Have you ever pondered over the prophecy in Ezekiel chapter 38? This intriguing piece of biblical scripture has captured the imaginations and hearts of many, sparking countless discussions, debates, and interpretations. The prophecy in Ezekiel chapter 38 is a cornerstone of Christian theology, a vivid narrative that speaks of a great war involving numerous nations. The prophecy, in its essence, is a foretelling of a vast conflict, a war that brings together various nations in a grand clash. It's a prophecy that has been studied, analyzed, and interpreted by Christian scholars and thought leaders across centuries, each bringing their unique perspective, each deciphering the cryptic verses to understand the nations that will play pivotal roles in this prophesied war. In the heart of this prophecy lies the question of its unfolding. When will this war occur? How close are we to the realization of this prophecy? These questions have fascinated scholars and believers alike, leading to numerous speculations based on the current global situation. This video sets forth to explore these very questions. Our aim is to delve into the prophecy, identify the nations that Christian thought leaders believe will be involved in this war, and assess the proximity of these events based on the current state of the world. We will navigate the intricate layers of this prophecy, piecing together the clues and insights that can shed light on this fascinating subject. Remember, prophecy is not just about prediction, it's about preparation. It's about understanding the signs of the times and discerning what lies ahead. It's about equipping ourselves with knowledge and faith as we navigate our journey in this world. So are you ready to embark on this enlightening exploration? To understand the prophecy in Ezekiel chapter 38 like never before? To unravel the nations involved in the prophesied war and gauge the nearness of these events? Let us delve into the nations and their potential roles in the prophesied war. Which nations do Christian thought leaders believe will be involved in the war prophesied in Ezekiel 38? Let's dive into the heart of the prophecy, where nations are named and roles are assigned. These nations, as believed by Christian scholars, are the key players in the prophesied war of Ezekiel 38. First, we have Russia. Some Christian thought leaders believe that Russia is referred to in the prophecy under the name Rosh. This is based on certain linguistic interpretations of the original Hebrew texts. It's suggested that Russia, as the northernmost nation, might lead a coalition of nations against Israel in this prophesied war. Next is Iran, referred to in the prophecy as Persia. Iran is a country with significant influence in the Middle East, and its potential role in the prophesied war is considered quite significant. Some believe that Iran could unite with Russia and other nations in an attack against Israel. Turkey, on the other hand, is believed to be the nation referred to as Gomer and Beth Togarma in Ezekiel's prophecy. Turkey's strategic location between Europe and Asia, along with its historical and cultural ties to both regions, makes it a crucial player in any potential conflict. Then we have Libya, referred to in the prophecy as Put. Libya's geographical location and historical connections with the Middle East could potentially align it with a coalition of nations against Israel. Lastly, we have Sudan, which some scholars believe is represented in the prophecy as Kush. Sudan's potential involvement in the prophesied war is seen as part of a larger alliance with the aforementioned nations. It's important to note that these interpretations vary among Christian scholars. The prophecy itself is layered with symbolism and metaphor, and its interpretation depends heavily on one's perspective and understanding of the biblical text. Each of these nations, Russia, Iran, Turkey, Libya, and Sudan, are believed to play significant roles in the war. The prophecy speaks of a coalition, a gathering of nations against Israel. And while we can't say for certain how each nation will contribute to this potential conflict, understanding their potential roles does provide us with a clearer picture of what this prophesied war might look like. Understanding the potential roles of these nations brings us closer to interpreting the prophecy. As we continue to explore this prophecy, we'll delve deeper into the current global situations that might serve as catalysts for this prophesied war. So stay tuned as we continue to unravel the mysteries of Ezekiel 38. How do current events align with this prophecy? Let's pause for a moment and consider our world in its present state. We live in an era of unprecedented global connectivity, where actions in one corner of the globe can reverberate in another. Yet, this interconnectedness doesn't always yield peace. Instead, it often amplifies geopolitical tensions, alliances, and conflicts, elements that seem to resonate with the prophecy of Ezekiel chapter 38. Looking at the Middle East, we see a region that's been a hotbed of conflict for decades, if not centuries. It's a melting pot of diverse cultures, religions, and politics, all intertwined in a complex web of alliances and hostilities. Could this be the setting of the prophesied war? In the prophecy, we see a coalition of nations rising against Israel. Today, some nations publicly declare their disdain for Israel, while others form covert alliances against it. These alliances, while not completely mirroring the nations listed in Ezekiel 38, do bear a striking resemblance. Let's consider Russia, a nation that holds significant influence in global politics. Its relationships in the Middle East are complex and multifaceted. It has managed to maintain a delicate balance, being a friend to nations that are traditionally at odds with each other. Could Russia's role in the region be significant in the fulfillment of this prophecy? Then there's Turkey, a nation that straddles the boundary between Europe and Asia, and between the West and the East. It's a country with a deep Islamic heritage, yet it has been a secular state for much of the last century. But with recent political shifts, there's been a resurgence of its Islamic identity. Could this be a precursor to Turkey aligning itself with the anti-Israel coalition as prophesied? We shouldn't overlook the role of Iran, a nation that has been at odds with Israel for decades. Its influence in the region, through its proxies and allies, is vast. Could Iran be the Persia mentioned in the prophecy, leading the charge against Israel? And what about the nations of Libya and Sudan? They're mentioned in the prophecy as allies in the coalition against Israel. Today, these nations are grappling with political instability and internal conflicts. Could these struggles be molding them into the roles prophesied in Ezekiel 38? It's important to remember that prophecy isn't always a straightforward roadmap to the future. It's more like a puzzle, with pieces that only fit together as events unfold. As we observe the global stage, we see pieces that could potentially fit into the prophecy of Ezekiel 38. But until every piece falls into place, we can't definitively say how close we are to its fulfillment. The alignment of current events with the prophecy provides us with insights into its potential fulfillment. Are we on the brink of the prophesied war? This is a question that has been asked repeatedly in various circles, especially among Christian thought leaders. As we delve into this, it's important to acknowledge that there are varying opinions on this matter. Yet the signs that we observe and interpret from the book of Ezekiel, chapter 38, are indeed intriguing. We have identified the nations mentioned in the prophecy, and we've analyzed the current global situations. All these elements paint a vivid picture, yet the exact timing of the prophesied war remains shrouded in mystery. The Bible reminds us that no one knows the day or the hour, and this holds true for the prophesied war. Some Christian thought leaders believe that we are at the doorstep of this prophesied war. They point to the escalating tensions among the identified nations, the rising conflicts, and the increasing global unrest. They see these as the birth pangs that precede the war spoken of in Ezekiel. Others, however, caution against jumping to conclusions. They argue that while we can certainly see some alignment with the prophetic narrative, it is crucial to avoid speculation and remain grounded in Scripture. They remind us that many events throughout history have seemed to align with biblical prophecy, yet the ultimate fulfillment is still to come. The proximity of the prophesied war, therefore, is a topic of intense debate and speculation. It's a question that invites us to study the Scriptures more deeply, to observe the world around us with discernment, and to live with an expectation of the fulfillment of God's Word. However, one thing is certain. Whether the prophesied war is imminent or still years away, it serves as a stark reminder of the urgency of the times we are in. It calls us to a deeper faith, a more fervent prayer life, and a stronger commitment to living out the teachings of Jesus Christ. The proximity of the prophesied war remains uncertain, yet the signs are intriguing. The prophecy in Ezekiel 38 is indeed a topic of immense intrigue. As we draw this conversation to a close, let's briefly revisit the main points we've examined together. We started by shedding light on the prophecy itself, a captivating vision given to the prophet Ezekiel, a foretelling of a great war involving multiple nations. The nations identified by Christian thought leaders as potential players in this prophecy include the likes of Persia, Cush, and Put, among others. These nations, as they were known in ancient times, correspond to modern regions such as Iran, Sudan, and Libya, respectively. Our exploration then led us to the current global situations. We live in a world that is constantly changing, where political alliances shift and new conflicts arise. We've seen tensions escalating in various parts of the globe, and the nations mentioned in the prophecy have not been immune to these. This dynamic global landscape brings a sense of immediacy and relevance to our examination of the prophecy. Finally, we delved into the potential proximity of the prophesied war. While it is crucial to note that prophetic timing remains a mystery, the convergence of current events with the nations mentioned in Ezekiel's prophecy certainly stirs thought-provoking questions about how close we might be to the realization of this prophetic war. However, as we ponder these possibilities, it is essential to remember that our objective is not to predict the future, but to gain a deeper understanding of the scriptures and the world we live in. We are not prophets, but students of prophecy. We seek not to bring fear, but awareness and discernment. As we observe the world around us, we continue to seek understanding and wisdom in interpreting these prophecies. Until next time, stay vigilant and keep exploring.